the others. So without further ado, and with great gratitude for being here in the United States with this very important event, let me please join me in welcoming Andreas Schleicher to the microphone.
Thank you very much. And first of all, I want to also thank the hosting and sponsoring organizations here. This is an impressive group of organizations that have joined this launch of our results and that have shown an interest in international benchmarking, something that we haven't seen all along in the United States, not always. I want to start with a few words talking about the context in which PISA takes place. Why does an Organization for Economic Development put so much emphasis on education? And there are three things I wanted to focus on. First of all, the context. Secondly, I wanted to talk about where the US stands on international benchmarks and comparisons. But I also want to speak about those countries that do best. What do the best performing systems in the world show us can be achieved in terms of quality of education, equity in the distribution of learning opportunities, and efficiency in education provision? And finally, talk to you about some of the policy levers that emerge from international benchmarking. Now, why does the OECD engage into this? We have seen, not just since PISA, but over the last years, that education has become the prime driver for the success of individuals and nations, economic success, social success. Skills and technology have flattened our world to an extent that everything that can be digitized, automated, and outsourced is being done now globally by the most efficient providers. And that has a deep impact on the way education systems operate, on competitiveness of nations. And today,